Well, the doctor is in as the Biden family mourns the loss of the vice president's son, Beau, who died over the weekend of brain cancer at just 46 years of age. The largest cancer research conference is now underway in Chicago, highlighting some new trends in cancer treatment that some are calling game changers. Dr. David Spigel is director of the Lung Cancer Research Program at Sarah Cannon Research Institute. He's attending the conference and he joins us now. And Dr. Spigel, I'd like to just ask you for a moment. I know you didn't treat Beau, but this headline certainly caught a lot of us off guard. Here he was so young, and we did know about some health issues that he had, but to know that he passed away so suddenly, brain cancer, came as a big shock. What was your reaction to the news? What does that tell us about the progression of cancer today?
First, let me express my sincere sympathy to the Biden family. Very sorry for that loss. Really terrible news, I think, for the country. As you point out, it's an aggressive cancer. I don't know the details. I don't think we all know the details of his care, but we know that he had a courageous battle with cancer. It's a difficult cancer to fight, as you say. Our tools, chemotherapy and radiation and surgery, can be effective, but these cancers tend to come back and tend to be hard for patients. What's exciting, as you say, is right now in Chicago, I'm fortunate to attend the annual international meeting, the ASCO meeting, looking at novel therapies, breakthroughs across tumor types. And as you point out, there's a lot of reasons to be excited. One of the big stories
Let me just stop you there, because let's just take a look at the trends. I know there's so many different studies coming out of that meeting, but one of the trends that seems to be coming out, and the New York Times was calling it one of the greatest advances that we've seen in years when it comes to cancer treatment, is this emergence of immunotherapy, of getting our own bodies to fight the disease. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's correct. This has been a story we've been a part of for the last several years, and we're seeing the fruits of that research coming forth at this conference. So we're seeing this idea that you can use the body's own immune system to fight cancer. We've seen major breakthroughs in lung cancer. We've seen breakthroughs in melanoma, very difficult, aggressive skin cancer. These results have come out these past few days. Quite exciting, but what's even more exciting is we're seeing these benefits start to show up in other cancers that we've never expected. Liver cancer, breast cancer, lymphomas, bladder cancer, a very exciting time for patients and families.
So why doesn't our body automatically fight cancer? What is it about the disease that requires us, it seems in these studies, to get an outside source, a medicine that will help trigger our body's response to fight it off?
Well, the simple answer is we're still trying to figure that out, but we're starting to learn more about the kinds of patients who may respond to therapies. There may be therapies where it doesn't matter what kind of cancer you have or what kind of background you have in terms of your own health. It may just be that this therapy helps you. But it appears clear that there are some situations where cancers respond to these therapies and some where they don't. But we're making progress in better understanding who those patients are. It's really a very exciting time in oncology.
How is it different than the traditional treatments? When I say traditional, I'm talking more specifically about chemotherapy, because I think most of us think of chemotherapy, if someone has cancer, as the major treatment they would receive.
Yeah, it's a great question. I don't want to say that chemotherapy is going away or radiation or surgery. Those are vital tools in fighting cancer, but very different. These are not therapies that traditionally cause side effects, the immunotherapies. These are not things that usually make you lose your hair, make your blood counts get low, make you feel sick. These are therapies, by and large, that are very well tolerated. Many patients don't even know they're getting them. I don't want to say that they're entirely safe. There are toxicities we need to watch for, things that are related to the immune system, but we're learning about these side effects, learning how to manage them. It's really a game changer in how we manage patients with cancer.
That is exciting news to know that there are some advances being made, especially at a time when we're dealing with another big national story about a loss. Dr. Spigel, great to have you on the program. Look forward to having you back. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.